New development directory. Under new development directory, develop a.java. In every class, minimum one constructor should be. In every class, minimum one constructor. Even in the abstract class also, minimum one constructor should be. Even in the abstract class also, minimum one constructor. If no constructors are there in any class, compiler providing a default constructor. If no constructors in any class, then compiler providing a default constructor. Constructor always concrete one. Constructor cannot be an abstract. Constructor cannot be an abstract. It should be always concrete. Why constructor cannot be an abstract? Constructors are not inheriting to subclass. If constructors are not inheriting to subclass, then it cannot be implemented further. So you should not declare constructors as an abstract. Constructors should not be declared as an abstract. The reason is, constructors are not inheriting to subclass. If constructor declared as an abstract, then where it will be getting implemented? As it is not inheriting to subclass, where it will be getting implemented?
Can you read the last statement?
You tell me.
The way the constructors are not inherited to subclass, after that the world was not audible.
Not audible. Constructors are not inheriting to subclass. Because of constructors are not inheriting to subclass, if any constructor is an abstract, where it will be getting implemented? If any constructor declared as an abstract, as it is not inheriting to subclass, it cannot be implemented further. We cannot declare constructors as an abstract. Always constructors should be concrete. Because of constructors not inheriting to subclass, if any constructor declared as an abstract, then where it will be getting implemented? As it is not inheriting to subclass, it will not be getting implemented further. That is why constructor always should be concrete. Constructor always should be concrete. Every class should have a minimum one constructor. That constructor should be concrete only. Even abstract class also should have a minimum one constructor, but that constructor is a concrete. Even abstract class also should have a minimum one constructor. That constructor always should be a concrete. It cannot be an abstract. So here class A is an abstract, every method is an abstract. Even though every method is an abstract, there is a concrete constructor. Even though we are not keeping any constructors in the class A, compiler defined one default constructor which is a concrete. Compiler defined one default constructor which is a concrete. Compiler defined one default constructor which is a concrete. Because of every class you should have a minimum one constructor, that constructor is always concrete. We cannot develop any class with 100% abstractness. Here class A containing all four methods as an abstract, still class A is not a 100% abstract one because of the concreteness of the constructor. So this point is very important. I repeat, please observe. Every class you should have a minimum one constructor, including abstract class. No matter class is a concrete or abstract, every class should have a minimum one constructor. Constructor cannot be an abstract, constructor always concrete. Why constructor cannot be an abstract? Constructors are not involving in the inheritance. If constructor not inheriting to the subclass, where abstract constructor can be implemented? If at all constructor declared as an abstract, as it is not inheriting to subclass, it cannot be implemented further. Whenever you develop something as an abstract, it should implement further some way. If constructor declared as an abstract, it cannot be implemented further. Why? Because it is not involving in the inheritance. It is not involving in the inheritance. It is not inheriting to subclass. It is not inheriting to subclass. Constructors are not involving in the inheritance. Constructors always concrete. Because of every constructor is a concrete, minimum one constructor should be in every class. You cannot develop a class as a 100% abstract one, even though class A containing every method as an abstract. Class A containing one concrete constructor. Because of that concrete constructor, because of that defined constructor, class A not qualifying as a 100% abstract one. Class A not qualifying as a 100% abstract one because of the concreteness through constructor. So we have seen several times, every class should have a minimum one constructor. Every class should have a minimum one constructor. Yesterday we have seen abstract methods. Declaring a method as an abstract, implementing same abstract method in the subclass. Methods are inheriting to subclass. Abstract method of superclass can be implemented in the subclass. Whatever method as an abstract in the superclass, same is inherited into subclass and getting implemented in the subclass. Already we have seen constructors are not inherited into subclass. Constructor of the superclass not inherited into subclass. If at all constructor declared as an abstract, it will not be getting implemented further as it is not inheriting to subclass. If it is not inheriting to subclass, then where it will be getting implemented? That is why constructors should not be constructors. Already we have seen one point like constructors should not be static. Construct is a non-static initializer. Constructor executing while object is creating. Constructor not executing while loading a class. So constructor should not be static. Static constructor, abstract constructor, not possible. We cannot develop a class with 100% abstractness without any kind of implementation. Here class A, even though every method is an abstract, there is a concrete constructor. Compiler only developed concrete constructor. Because of the concrete constructor, class A not qualified as a 100% abstract. Now, to develop a 100% abstract work, we had to go for interfaces. Interfaces are mainly for achieving 100% abstractness. Interfaces are mainly for achieving 100% abstractness. Interfaces are introduced mainly to achieve 100% abstractness. We cannot provide any implementation in the interface. It's 100% abstract one. We cannot provide any implementation in the interface. We cannot provide any implementation We cannot provide any implementation in the interface. We cannot develop any constructor. Compiler also not providing a constructor in the interface. In the interface body, we cannot develop any constructor. Even compiler also not providing any constructor in the interface. Thank you. inside interface, we cannot develop any defined methods. Inside interface, we cannot develop any defined methods. Inside the interface, we can provide only constants and abstract methods. Inside the interface, we can provide only constants and abstract methods. Constants and abstract methods. What is the constant that will come to mind? We already know abstract methods. Inside interface, we can provide only constants and abstract methods. Now, interface can become a member of the Java file like a class and abstract class. Interface can become a member of the Java file like a class and abstract class. Interface can become a member of the Java file like a class and abstract class. While compiling, even for the interface also, class file is generated. While compiling, even for the interface also, class file is generated. Even for the interface also, class file is generated. By default, interface is an abstract. As it is 100% abstract one, by default it is an abstract. We don't require specifying explicitly as an abstract. By default, interface is an abstract. We don't require specifying explicitly abstract interface B. Still, if you want to, you can do. Abstract keyword is optional for the interfaces, as every interface is 100% abstract. Abstract keyword is very optional to the interfaces. If you wanted, you can declare abstract interface B. Both are one and the same. We don't require to provide abstract keyword explicitly to the interfaces. can save this file as a b.java and compile. You will get a class file. So, the class. Save it as b.java. Compile it. You will be getting a class file. Come to the next one. Save it as c.java. You will be getting compile time error because of a defined method, concrete method, implemented method. Interface will not be allowing defined method, concrete method. Interface will not be allowing any defined method or concrete method. You'll get compile time error. Develop interface D. Save it as a D.java. We cannot develop a constructor in the interface. Again, you will be getting compile time error. We cannot develop a constructor in the interface. Again, we will be getting a compile time error. Thank you. We cannot develop IIB or SIB inside interface. We cannot develop IIB or SIB inside interface. Again, you will be getting compile time error. Compilation error. Come to the next one. This is compiling very successfully. We are keeping one constant and one abstract method. So here abstract keyword is optional. Why? Because every method is an abstract. Inside an interface, while declaring a method, abstract keyword is optional. While declaring a method, abstract keyword is optional. While declaring a method, abstract keyword is optional. Every method is an abstract itself. That is why abstract keyword is not a mandatory. Still, if you wanted, you can provide an abstract while declaring a method in the interface. While declaring a method in the interface, abstract keyword is optional. Only declared methods are allowed, not the defined methods. Only methods with the declaration is allowed. Only methods with the declaration in the interface. While declaring a method, you are supposed to keep abstract keyword explicitly. Whereas in case of interfaces, every method is an abstract. While declaring a method, abstract keyword is optional. While declaring a method, abstract keyword is optional. While declaring a method, abstract keyword is optional. Then the first one is a constant. Always constant should be initialized. Every constant should be initialized, then only it will become a constant. Every constant should be initialized. You will be knowing more about the constant while covering final. Every constant is a static and final. Because of that, it should be initialized. Please remember, every constant is a static and final. Every constant is a static and final. That is why it should be initialized. As it is a static and final, it should be initialized. You will be knowing the reason while covering final keyword. Separate topic is the. At the time, you will be knowing more about constant. Static and final is a constant. Static and final is a constant. Inside interface, only constants and abstract methods. I is a constant, S21 is a abstract method. Only constants and abstract methods are allowed in the interface. Interface is introduced for achieving 100% abstractness. No concreteness is allowed inside the interface. No concreteness is allowed inside a interface. No concreteness is allowed inside an interface. Only two types of members we can provide in the interface. One is constants. Second one is abstract methods. Here I is a constant. S21 is an abstract method. What is a constant? If any variable is a static and final, then it is a constant. What is a method? If method doesn't have a, what is abstract method? If method doesn't have an implementation, if it is just to declare, ending with a semicolon. So here, I is a constant, S21 is a abstract method. I is a constant. Every constant should be static and final. Every abstract method should be just declared. Here, I is a constant. S21 is abstract method. So now, every attribute of the interface like I, static and final, we don't require to provide static and final explicitly. Still, if you wanted, you can provide static and final for the I. Every attribute of the interface is a constant. Every attribute of the interface by default is static and final. So I is a static and final. We don't require to provide explicitly static and final. Still, if you wanted, you can provide explicitly static and final. By default, every attribute of the interface is static and final. Every attribute of the interface is static and final. Every attribute of the interface is static and final. So here, we didn't declare I as a static, we didn't declare I as a final, but I is a static and final only. If you wanted, you can provide static and final explicitly. Let's do one. Every method of an interface is an abstract by default. If you wanted, you can declare explicitly as an abstract. Every method of an interface is an abstract by default. If you want to, you can declare a method as an abstract. You can go for abstract void test one. Now, very important one, every member of the interface is a public. Please observe. Every member of the interface is a public. Every member of the interface is a public by default. Every member of the interface is a public by default. So here I is a public, test one also public. Every member of the interface is a public by default. Now I is a public, static and final. Test one is a public and abstract. Please observe. Every field of the interface, every property of the interface, every attribute of the interface. Attribute, field, property, like I. It's a global one. It's not a local to any method. I is a global to F. I is a field of the F, property of the F, attribute of the F. I is a public static and final. I is a public static and final. We don't require to specify explicitly public static final. Still, if you wanted, you can provide public static final or only public or only static or only final. By default, every attribute of the interface is a public static and final. Every field of the interface, public static final. Every attribute of the interface, public static final. Every property of the interface, public static final. Every field of the interface, public static final. Next one. Every method of the interface is a public and abstract. Every method of the interface is public and abstract. By default, every method of the interface is public and abstract. Every method of the interface is public and abstract. Every method of the interface is public and abstract. Next, very important point. No member of the interface can be declared as a private or protected. No member of the interface can be declared as a private or protected. No member of the interface can be declared as a private or protected. I cannot be declared explicitly as a private or protected. Testament also cannot be declared as a private or protected. If you wanted, only public is allowed. Only one access level to the members of the interface, that is public. So if you are not keeping any access level keyword, by default it comes under public. I is a public, test one also public. Every member of the interface is a public by default. Only public is allowed to keep explicitly. You cannot keep a private or protected keywords. If you don't want any keyword of the access level, leave it. By default, it is a public only. By default, it is a public. I is a public, test one also public. By default, I is a public, test one also public. If you don't want any access level, leave it. By default, it is a public. If you want to give the access level explicitly to any member of the interface, then you have to keep only public. You have to keep only public. Other than public, it is not allowed. So where default is treated as a public, this is very important for the interviews. So here default is treated as a public. For the members of the interface, default scope is nothing but public. In general, default scope is a package scope. We have seen very clearly while covering access levels. In general, default scope is a package scope. Only in one place, default scope is a public. That is for the members of the interface. Members of the interface by default public. Private is not allowed. Protected is not allowed. Members of the interface by default. Members of the interface by default. Members of the interface by default. It's only public. I cannot be declared as a private or protected. Test 1 also cannot be declared as a private or protected. Only public is allowed. If you are not keeping also, it will come under public. Then, by default, interface itself is not a public, only members of the interface are public. By default, interface itself is not a public, only members of the interface are public. This point is very important. By default, interface itself is not a public, only members of the interface are public. I is a public by default, test 1 also public by default, F is not a public by default. By default, interface itself is not a public, F is not a public, only members of the F are public. Most of the beginners are thinking like even interface is also public. Here F is not a public, only I is a public, test 1 is a public. By default, interface itself is not a public. Only members of the interface are public. Members of the interface are public. F is not a public. These are the few points related to interface. Define a hedge. Thank you. Only constants are there in the interface. In the H interface, only constants. All are public static final. No matter whether you provided explicitly public or not, static or not, final or not. Every constant of the interface, public static final. I is a public static final, J also public static final, K also. M also, N also, P also. Public static final. These three keywords are optional to the constants of the interface. Public static final. These three are optional to the interfaces. All these constants should be initialized. See, every field of the interface should be initialized. All are initialized. So syntactically correct. Compilation will be successful. But H is not a public here. By default, interface is not a public. Only members of the interface. All are constants. Syntactically correct. Compilation success. Come to the next one. Are you getting compile time? Compilation error. Let me say, static and final, it should be initialized. It is not initializing. You will be getting compile time error. Every constant should be initialized, then only it will be called as a constant. So when a variable is called as a constant, initialization should be, but reinitialization should not be. When it will be called as a constant, it should have only one value, not multiple values. Initialization and no reinitialization. So this is giving compile time error. Thank you. Every method is a public and abstract. All these five methods are public and abstract only. All these five methods are public and abstract. All these five methods are public and abstract. Even though no public keyword, no abstract keyword for test 1, test 1 is a public and abstract. Test 2, it is also public and abstract. Test 3 also. All these five methods are public and abstract. You can go for public abstract or abstract public. Every method of the interface by default public and abstract. Public is optional, abstract also optional. Compilation will be very successful. Syntactically correct. Observable point. J is not a public. Every method is public and abstract. Thank you.
What is implements while designing any of the class by making use of an interface? You have to use implements keyword. Implements keyword is used while developing a subclass to the interface. Case is subclass to A. Whenever you are developing subclass to the interface, you have to use implements. Implements keyword should be used. While designing a subclass to the interface, A is the interface, K is the class. You have to use implements implements keyword should be a dotted line from a subclass to the interface. Implements keyword, it should be a dotted line. It's not a solid line. In case of extends, it should be solid line. In case of extends a solid line from a subclass to superclass. In case of implements, a dotted line from a subclass to the interface. It's a dotted line, it's not a solid line. Implements a keyword. From A, abstract test 1, public abstract test 1 inheriting to K. So that should be implemented in the K to become a K as a concrete. From interface A, public abstract test 1 inheriting to K. Inside a K, you have to implement test 1 to make K as a concrete. We implemented. K doesn't have any abstract methods. K doesn't have any abstract methods. We don't require to declare K as an abstract. Compiler not forcing us to declare a K as an abstract. Compiler not forcing us to declare a K as an abstract. While implementing interface methods in the subclass, you have to implement with a public. Please remember this point. While implementing interface methods in the subclass, you have to implement with a public. While implementing interface methods in the subclass, while implementing interface methods in the subclass,
while implementing interface methods in the subclass, you have to use a public. Why? Because every method of the interface is public by default. Every method of the interface is a public by default. While implementing any interface method in the subclass, public keyword is a mandatory. This is very important. Most of the people not knowing this point. Interface method is a public. While implementing public method, you have to use a public. Inside a K class, default is not a public. Default is a package. Come on. In any of the classes, default is a package, scope, not a public. We cannot implement public member with a default scope. Scope should not be reduced while implementing or while providing any different definition. Scope can be same scope or it can be incremented. It should not be decremented. The default scope of the interface method is a public. Default scope of a class method, it's a package. Lot of difference between public and package. You're trying to decrement scope while choosing from public to package. Inside interface, by default, it's a public. Interface method is a public. Interface method should be implemented with the public. Then, interface is a 100% abstract one. Yesterday we have seen very clearly, you cannot create an object with the abstract. For the interface, you cannot create an object. Why? Because it's a 100% abstract one. We cannot create an object with interface. We cannot create an object to interface. Why? Because it's 100% abstract. We cannot create an object to interface. Interface is 100% abstract to one. We cannot create an object to interface. Interface is a 100% abstract one. If anybody attempting to create an object to interface, he'll get compile time error. But we can create a reference variable. For the interface, we can create a reference variable. Interface can be used wherever a derived data type is required. Interface can be used for the data type purpose. Interface can be used for the data type purpose. Interface can be used for the data type purpose. Interface can be used for the data type purpose. Wherever data type is required, there and all we can use the interface. Here A2 data type is a interface type. To specify the data type of A2, we use it A. To specify data type of A2, we have used interface A. To specify data type of A2, wherever data type is required, there and all we can use interface, but we cannot create an object with interface. Interface is 100% abstract to us. We cannot create an object to interface, but we can use the interface wherever data type is required. Copy the same. Two methods are there in the A interface. Both we have to implement in the subclass. L is a subclass to A. L is a subclass to A. L is a subclass to A. Inside a L, two methods are implemented. L become a concrete. You can create an object to L, but you cannot create an object to A, but you can create an object to reference variable to A. This will be compiled and very successful. This is compiling successfully. Running also success. Copy paste. Thank you. We cannot create an object to A and B. A is the interface, 100% abstract to one. B is abstract to class. We cannot create an object to A and B. B should be declared as an abstract here. The reason is B containing unimplemented test. B class getting test 1 and test 2 from A. Between test 1 and test 2, only test 1 got implemented, test 2 not implemented. Only test 1 got implemented, test 2 is not implemented. Because of that, B should be declared as an abstract. B is declaring as an abstract. A and B both are abstract. M is a subclass to B. M is a subclass to B. From B, two methods are inheriting. Between these two, one is an abstract. Abstract one got implemented. Abstract one got implemented. M became a concrete. No abstract methods inside M. Creating an object to M, calling test one, test two. This will be compiling, running successfully. Copy the same, guys. Now you cannot create an object to A, B, C. You cannot create an object to A, B, C. Develop N, which is a subclass to C. You can create an object to N. You can call test 1, test 2, test 3. N is a concrete. All these points are very simple. Three methods are inheriting from A to B. Among these three methods, only test 1 got implemented. Among these three methods, only test 1 got implemented. Other two methods are not implemented. C extends B. From B, three methods inheriting, among them, one already got implemented, one is implementing in the C, still one more not implemented. Because of that, C should be declared as an obstruct. Then N extends to C. From C, three methods are inheriting. Among these three, first two are obstruct, first two are already implemented, the third one not implemented, that is implementing now. Compilation, very success, running also very success. Thank you.
minutes the class class will get over. First will get over. O extends B, implement CA. Same class can have a extends and implements. Same class can have a extends and implements. Implements a keyword. It's a dotted line. Extends a keyword. It's a solid line. Same class can have it. Extends and implements. O implements, O extends. O class implementing and extending. O class. One condition to be followed is, everybody please observe, the order always it should be extends and implements. You should not go for implements and extends. It's a part of the syntax. You have to go for first extends, then implements. You should remember this order. Extends and implements.
extends and implements extends and implements order should be extends and implements. O is a concrete, you can create an object to O. You can call test 1 and test 2. Syntactically correct, compilation will be successful. Copy the same program. P implements A comma B. P implements A comma B. P implements A comma P. Thank you. one class can implement, one class can implement any number of super interfaces. One class we can implement any number of super interfaces. Same class can implement any number of super interfaces. One class can implement any number of super interfaces. One class can implement any number of super interfaces. This is very important point. Multiple inheritance is allowed only in case of interfaces. Multiple inheritance, it is possible only through interfaces. Same class implementing A and B. Multiple inheritance is possible only through interfaces, any number of super interfaces. Class can implement with any number of super interfaces. A class can implement with any number of super interfaces. A class can implement with any number of super interfaces. In Java, multiple inheritance is possible only through interfaces. In Java, multiple inheritance is possible only through interfaces. Implements A comma B comma C comma D comma any number of interfaces. If we consider C++, multiple inheritance is possible through classes and also interfaces. By using classes also we can achieve multiple inheritance in case of C++. Whereas in case of Java, multiple inheritance is possible only through interfaces. Multiple inheritance is only through interfaces. In C++, we can achieve multiple inheritance through classes also, not only through interfaces. Classes and interfaces both. But in Java, only through interfaces. There is a reason why Java is not supporting multiple inheritance through classes. You will come to know that in the next class itself. Very simple. A class can implement any number of super interfaces. A class can implement with any number of super interfaces. Develop the next program.
C extends CA comma B.